This weather report is proudly brought to you by Dettol No Touch, making hand washing so easy, kids want to do it by themselves.
Tim Bailey's here again, and Tim, May is on a giant high.
Quite literally, Sandra Sully, it is. Good evening, everybody. The dominant feature is the high. Has been for 2 weeks, hence 16 rain-free days. Big blue skies right across New South Wales. Little bit of moisture, maybe from the Hunter Coast, sneaking up towards the Queensland border, right on the coastal fringe, but really, temps expected to be 2 or 3 degrees above average. Big and blue and fabulous right through until next Wednesday. Now, we've lobbed into Lane Cove, as I told you, prior to the commercial break. This is the house of Annabelle. Round of applause, please, for Annabelle. Because we understand how difficult it is for mums, and at this time of the day, my word, it's a beauty, and I don't get invited many places. This is a plug for Australia's biggest morning tea. Now, the Cancer Council is going to raise $11 million by hosting these morning teas right across May and June. We need to do it because one in two Australians, by the time they're 85, will be diagnosed with cancer, and unfortunately, we lose a person to the disease one every 12 minutes. Now, Joe, for 6 years, you've been having one of these little shindigs.
I have.
Yeah, here's cheers. What do you do and how much dough do you raise?
Each year I've raised between $100 and $300, and it's just been a mix of mums through mums group and schools, and we just get together, have a chat and have a cup of tea.
It is. Look, and it's got a lovely, really warm vibe. Ellie's along and so is Scarlett and everyone, including the grandmother of the year, bring her in, Rosemary. She's a bit shy, but have a look at her work, ladies and gentlemen. This is MasterChef quality, Rosemary.
Definitely.
Now, you tell me there's some beer in the fridge for after as well?
Well, I'm not supposed to say that.
I love you, Rosemary. I love you. And thank you again, Annabelle, for having us. Please get to biggestmorningtea.com.au. We will raise $11 million, the hundreds and $200 that Joe, God bless her, has been doing for 5 or 6 years. Everyone, it's the warmth, it's the little bits that count, and it ends up. They want to beat cancer. Is there a better mission statement out there? Righto to the weather. Promising blue skies, as bright as and pretty as those, ladies and gentlemen. Not the right colour, but I promise you, big blue skies. And let's get to the satellite tonight. And a low pressure trough pushes cloud through WA and the Bight, and some high cloud also tickles the top of the Territory and Queensland. The map tomorrow, the big high generates moist southeast winds along the east coast. A front and trough switch on showers and storms in southern WA. Otherwise, it's blue skies before your very eyes. Rainfall map tomorrow. Showers along the east coast, damp and unsettled in parts of WA and sneaking into South Oz as well. Around Australia tomorrow, Brisbane, mostly fine, possible shower. Canberra, fog and frost, then sunny, down to -4, top of 16. Hobart, partly cloudy, possible light evening rain in Adelaide and Perth, a shower or two developing. New South Wales tomorrow, possible shower, Lismore and Coffs Harbour. Early frostless story, then sunny days. Tamworth, Dubbo, Orange, Wagga Wagga, Broken Hill, Nowra and Bega. Just a magnificent autumn spread of blue sky. Richmond doing it the same way. Early fog and a light frost, 21 degrees for a big blue one. Penrith, early fog, then sunny. Parramatta, sunshine, mostly sunny. Terry Hills, Campbelltown and Wollongong. Official forecast, sunny apart from patchy morning fog in the west for Sydney and tops of 21 degrees, 2 above average. The outlook, outstanding the look. Mostly sunny Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. Tuesday and Wednesday, I fib not, and in the west, temperatures anywhere between 2 and 3 degrees above average. Australia's biggest morning, tea.com.au. Thanks for having us at your place.